हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स डीजे गणित। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ सीरीज नोन एज पावर सीरीज एंड इट्स कन्वर्जेंस। सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज पावर सीरीज। सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ पावर सीरीज। ए सीरीज ऑफ द फॉर्म सी जीरो प्लस सी वन टाइम्स एक्स माइनस ए प्लस c2 टाइम्स स्क्वायर ऑफ x माइनस ए प्लस c3 टाइम्स क्यूब ऑफ x माइनस ए एंड सो ऑन, वेर दिस a एंड cn, दैट इज c0, c1, c2 एंड सो ऑन आर कॉन्स्टेंट्स। सो इन दिस सीरीज वी कैन सी वी हैव रिटन पावर्स ऑफ x माइनस ए। पावर्स ऑफ x माइनस ए आर इंक्रीजिंग। Each term contains power of x minus a. In first term also we have zero power of x minus a. Here we can write c0 times x minus a raised to 0. So this series contains powers of x minus a. Therefore it is known as power series about this fixed point x equal to a. Or we can say that it is a power series in powers of x minus a. In sigma notation we can rewrite this series as sigma n equal to 0 to infinity c n x minus a raised to n. This number a is called the center of power series. So the constant a is called the center of power series. Now if we consider a equal to 0 in this series, then our series becomes c0 plus c1 into x plus c2 into x square plus c3 into x cube and so on, which we can rewrite as sigma cn times x raised to n, n is from 0 to infinity. So this is a power series about x equal to 0 or power series in powers of x. So center of this power series is x equal to 0. So these are the examples of power series: sigma n equal to 0 to infinity x raised to n by n factorial, which we can write as 1 plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial and so on. So this is a power series with center x equal to 0. Here 1 minus 1 by 2 times x minus 2 plus 1 by 4 times x minus 2 square and so on, which we can rewrite in sigma notation as sigma minus 1 by 2 raised to n times x minus 2 raised to n. So this is a power series about center x equal to 2, or it is a power series with powers of x minus 2. So now if we have power series, then in power series we have variable x. So for different values of x we will obtain different series of numbers from the power series. Suppose I consider x equal to 1 in this series. This series for x equal to 1 reduces to 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial and so on. If we consider another value of x, we will obtain another series of numbers. So for different values of x we have different series of numbers. So in this topic we are interested that for which values of x our power series is convergent, or for which values of x our power series is not convergent or divergent. So we will discuss how to check the convergence of power series. So before that we require ratio test to check the convergence of power series. We have seen ratio test for series with positive terms. Here we are writing ratio test for series with any terms, either positive or negative. So suppose sigma an is a series which is either positive or negative or combination of terms. So let sigma an be any series, and suppose that limit of absolute value of an plus 1 divided by an equal to L. In earlier lectures we have seen ratio test for positive series only. So in that case we have taken limit of an plus 1 over n an equal to L, because in that ratio test we had considered all the terms of the series as positive, and this ratio test we are writing for any series. So to match with that ratio test we are taking absolute value of an plus 1 over an. So this ratio test which we have discussed before this lecture is particular case of this ratio test. So this is general form of ratio test. So let sigma an be any series, and suppose that limit of absolute value of an plus 1 divided by an as n tends to infinity is capital L, then the series is absolutely convergent if value of L is less than 1. And we know that if series is absolutely convergent, it is convergent. So series will be convergent if L is less than 1, because it is absolutely convergent if L is less than 1. The series is divergent if L is greater than 1 or if L is infinity, and the test fails if L equal to 1. So for the convergence of power series we will use this form of ratio test. We will consider limit of absolute value of an plus 1 over an, and then we will be able to decide the convergence depending on the value of L. If L is less than 1, series is absolutely convergent. If L is greater than 1 or L is infinity, series is divergent. And if L equal to 1, test fails. So we consider one example. For what values of x does the following power series converge? So here series is x minus x square by 2 plus x cube by 3 and so on, which we have written in sigma notation as sigma x raised to n by n times minus 1 raised to n minus 1 n equal to 1 to infinity. So we apply ratio test for this power series. So we consider this as an. Let an equal to minus 1 raised to n minus 1 x raised to n by n. Therefore an plus 1 is obtained by replacing n by n plus 1. So minus 1 raised to n plus 1 minus 1, that is minus 1 raised to n x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now we find out limit of absolute value of an plus 1 over an. So here we have written an plus 1 divided by an. This we can rewrite by taking reciprocal of this. So it is 1 over minus 1 raised to n minus 1 n divided by x raised to n. Now absolute value of minus 1 raised to n or absolute value of minus 1 raised to n minus 1 is always 1. And this x raised to n we write as x raised to n into x. So x raised to n will cancel out, and we are left with x into n divided by n plus 1, and in the absolute values. Now this n and n plus 1 are positive, so this we can rewrite as absolute value of x into n divided by n plus 1. Now this absolute value of x is independent of n, so we take it outside and we find out limit of n over n plus 1 as n tends to infinity. So we can see as n tends to infinity we have infinity by infinity form, so we use L'Hospital rule. So here we consider derivative of n, which is 1, and derivative of n plus 1 is 1 plus 0. Derivative is taken with respect to variable n, and limit of 1 is 1. So we obtain absolute value of x as the limit of absolute value of an plus 1 over an. So by the ratio test, if absolute value of x is less than 1, series is absolutely convergent and hence convergent, and if absolute value of x is greater than 1, given power series is divergent. So we have written here, therefore by the ratio test, given series is absolutely convergent and hence convergent if mod x is less than 1. Mod x is less than 1 means minus 1 less than x less than 1. So if our x lies in open interval minus 1 to 1, series is absolutely convergent and hence convergent, and divergent if mod x is greater than 1. So outside this interval, series is divergent. Suppose this is real line minus 1 to 1. So if our x is in this part, series is convergent, and outside this part, series is divergent. So we have to think about endpoints of this interval, because test fails if mod x equal to 1, that is if x equal to plus or minus 1. So ratio test is inconclusive at endpoints of this interval. So at these two endpoints, x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 1, we will decide the convergence by taking x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 1 in the given series. So the ratio test fails if mod x equal to 1, that is if x equal to plus or minus 1. So first we check convergence at x equal to 1. So if we put x equal to 1 in given series, then this series at x equal to 1 becomes 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 and so on. So it is alternating harmonic series. At x equal to 1, given series reduces to 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. This is written as sigma minus 1 raised to n minus 1 times 1 by n, which is alternating harmonic series, and we can check that it is convergent by alternating series test or by Leibniz theorem. So this I have written directly. For the proof of this, you can refer my lecture number 11 on my channel of this topic. You can refer lecture number 11 of series about alternating series test. In that lecture, I have shown that this alternating harmonic series is convergent by Leibniz theorem. And here we can write directly that this is alternating harmonic series and it is convergent. So at x equal to 1, given series is convergent. Now if we put x equal to minus 1 in given series, we can see our series will reduce to, suppose I put x equal to minus 1, first term is minus 1, second term is minus 1 square, that is 1 by 2. Here x cube, that is minus 1 cube, which is minus 1 by 3. So all the terms are negative for x equal to minus 1. So when x is minus 1, given series becomes minus 1, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3 and so on, which we can rewrite as minus 1 divided by n, and this is equal to minus 1 times sigma 1 by n. Now this series is divergent, it is harmonic series or P series with P equal to 1. So this series is divergent, and we know that if series is divergent and if we consider constant multiple of divergent series, then it remains divergent. So this series is divergent at x equal to minus 1. So power series is divergent at x equal to minus 1. So we have seen that in this interval, series is convergent if x is in between minus 1 and 1, and at x equal to 1 also series is convergent. So our series is convergent for those values of x which lies in the open close interval minus 1 to 1, and outside this interval series is divergent. So here divergent, here also divergent. So hence given power series is convergent if x belongs to, if and only if x belongs to open close interval minus 1 to 1. So here this interval in which power series is convergent, that interval is known as interval of convergence of power series. and the radius of this interval, that is, if we consider length of this interval, length of the interval is 1 minus minus 1 equal to 2. And if we divide this length by 2, that is known as radius of convergence. So for this interval, length is 2, and if we divide length by 2, we obtain 1. So this 1 is called the radius of convergence of the power series. So here we have seen that if mod x is less than 1, power series is absolutely convergent. So this number 1 is nothing but radius of convergence of given power series. Now this is true for every power series. If we have any power series, either in powers of x or in powers of x minus a, for every power series we will always have that number r. Suppose we consider general form of power series, so for every power series there exists a positive number denoted by capital R, such that power series is absolutely convergent if absolute value of x minus a is less than r, and it is divergent if absolute value of a x minus a is greater than r. I repeat again, for every power series there exists a number r which is positive, such that if modulus of x minus a is less than r, power series is convergent, in fact absolutely convergent. And if mod x minus a is greater than r, power series is divergent. So this number r is called the radius of convergence of power series. Now if we simplify this, that power series is absolutely convergent in this interval, this we can rewrite as minus r less than x minus a less than r. Again we add a to every term, so we have a minus r less than x less than a plus r. So mod x minus a less than r is equivalent to x belongs to interval from a minus r to a plus r. So this r is nothing but length of this interval divided by 2. If we find out length of this interval, it is last end point minus first end point, that is equal to 2r. And if we divide the length by 2, it is nothing but radius of convergence. So radius of convergence is nothing but length of interval of convergence divided by 2. So this is true for every power series. Now for some power series we have the for there are some power series which are convergent for all x. Then in that case radius of convergence is infinite. There are some power series which are convergent at only at center, that is only at x equal to a. So in that case radius of convergence is r equal to 0. And there are some power series which are convergent either in open interval or either in open close interval or either in close interval. So for every power series these are the only possibilities. Power series is convergent either at only one point or at all points or in the interval of any of this type. So this interval is known as interval of convergence and r is known as radius of convergence. So we have written all these things, that convergence of power series sigma cn x minus a raised to n equal to 0 to infinity is described by वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग थ्री केसेस, फॉर एवरी पावर सीरीज देर आर थ्री पॉसिबिलिटीज, देर एग्जिस्ट ए पॉजिटिव नंबर आर सच दैट द पावर सीरीज इज एब्सोल्युटली कन्वर्जेंट इफ एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स माइनस ए इज लेस देन आर, एंड इट इज डाइवर्जेंट इफ एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स माइनस ए इज ग्रेटर देन आर. दैट इज पावर सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट इन द इंटरवल ए माइनस आर टू ए प्लस आर एंड डाइवर्जेंट आउटसाइड दिस इंटरवल. सेकेंड पॉसिबिलिटी इज पावर सीरीज इज एब्सोल्युटली कन्वर्जेंट फॉर ऑल एक्स, इन दैट केस वैल्यू ऑफ आर इज इन्फिनिटी एंड पावर सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट एट एक्स इक्वल टू ए ओनली विच इज नथिंग बट सेंटर, सो इन दैट केस वैल्यू ऑफ आर इज जीरो. सो द नंबर आर इज कॉल्ड द रेडियस ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ पावर सीरीज एंड द इंटरवल ऑफ रेडियस आर इन विच पावर सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट, द इंटरवल ऑफ रेडियस आर विथ सेंटर एक्स इक्वल टू ए इज कॉल्ड द इंटरवल ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस, दैट इज ए माइनस आर टू ए प्लस आर. नाउ दिस इंटरवल कैन बी ओपन इंटरवल लाइक दिस और इट कैन बी क्लोज इंटरवल लाइक दिस और इट कैन बी हाफ ओपन, दैट इज ओपन क्लोज इंटरवल ए माइनस आर टू ए प्लस आर और क्लोज ओपन इंटरवल. सो द लास्ट पॉसिबिलिटी इज ए माइनस आर टू ए प्लस आर. सो टाइप ऑफ इंटरवल विल डिपेंड ऑन द बिहेवियर ऑफ पावर सीरीज एट एंड पॉइंट्स. इफ पावर सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट एट बोथ द एंड पॉइंट्स, इंटरवल विल बी क्लोज इंटरवल. इफ पावर सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट एट वन एंड पॉइंट एंड इट इज नॉट कन्वर्जेंट एट अनदर एंड पॉइंट, इंटरवल विल बी हाफ ओपन. सो इंटरवल ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस मे बी ओपन क्लोज्ड और हाफ ओपन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पर्टिकुलर सीरीज. नाउ द पॉइंट्स एक्स फॉर विच मोड एक्स माइनस ए इज लेस देन आर, आर इज रेडियस ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस, द सीरीज इज एब्सोल्युटली कन्वर्जेंट एंड हेंस कन्वर्जेंट. Now, as we have discussed, if the series is absolutely convergent for all x, radius of convergence is r equal to infinity, and if the series converges only at x equal to a, radius of convergence is r equal to 0. So, this is all about power series. We are using ratio test to check the convergence of power series, and in the next lecture, we will do some more problems on power series or on the convergence of power series. So this is all about this lecture. I hope you understand it and you like it. Thank you very much.